subhanahu wa ta'ala to the people. Meanwhile, the soldiers came and surrounded the house Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was staying in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to the rescue of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to the rescue of all the God-fearing people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam alive to the heavens and saved Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam from the Jews. The soldiers had surrounded the house of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. One of the soldiers came in and began to search for Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Whilst he was searching for Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Allah changed the face of this soldier to look like that of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. When the other soldiers came and found that he resembled Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, the other soldiers arrested this soldier, thinking that he was Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. This soldier began to deny, but they refused to believe him, thinking that he was a culprit and it is only normal for one that is guilty to deny the charge. They arrested him and they took him, and finally it was this person that they crucified, and it was this person who died on the cross. And this is the belief of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the belief of the Muslims, that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was not crucified, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam has not died, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was raised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the heavens. We believe that at this moment in time, as I address you and you listen to the reminder, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam is alive and he is in the heavens. And we believe that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will return before the end of time as a major sign of Qiyamah. The Quran has made this concept very clear. The Quran says, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِّنْ مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ إِلَّا اتِّبَاءَ الظَّنِّ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ, and they did not kill Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ, and they did not even crucify Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ, but the resemblance of Jesus of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was put over another man, and it was this man they killed. وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِّنْ, and those that differ therein are full of doubt. مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ إِلَّا اتِّبَاءَ الظَّنِّ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا, they have no certain knowledge, they are following nothing but conjecture. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا, the Quran says, certainly did not kill Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him alive, raised him unto him. Another verse of the Quran states, إِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى إِنِّي مُتَوَفِّيكَ وَرَافِئُكَ إِلَيَّ وَمُطَهِّرُكَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَجَاعِلُ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوكَ فَوْقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ ثُمَّ إِلَيَّ مَرْجِعُكُمْ وَأَحْكُمُ بَيْنَكُمْ فِيمَا كُنْتُمْ فِيهِ تَخْتَلِفُونَ. إِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى إِنِّي مُتَوَفِّيكَ وَرَافِئُكَ إِلَيَّ وَمُطَهِّرُكَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Isa that I will raise you unto me alive and I will purify you from the kuffar. Another verse of the Quran states, وَإِن مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكُونُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا. There is not a single section of the people of the book, but they will believe in Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam before Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam's death. That is when Allah, when Isa alayhi salam descends and kills the Dajjal, the Jews and Christians will believe that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam has been alive all this time, and they will believe in him, and they will believe and they will know that he had not died, and the Jews have been lying, and on the day of judgment Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will be a witness against them. Besides these verses of the Quran, there are many ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which clearly state that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam is alive, that he did not die, and Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend before the end of time. He will live for a period of time and then he will die a physical death. It is narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ عِيسَى لَمْ يَمُؤْ وَإِنَّهُ رَاجِعٌ إِلَيْكُمْ قَبْلَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam did not die, and he will return to you before the day of judgment. There are many ahadith which clearly state this. The ulama have written that these ahadith of Rasulullah have reached the status of tawatir. They are mutawatir. That means there is no doubt whatsoever in his dissension. And it is essential that we relate this story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, how he was born and how he was raised, to our children. Especially now, it is the month of November. It is the month in which they are told all sorts of things regarding Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, which totally contradict the Quran and the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is essential that we teach them the belief of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. If we do not take up the responsibility of conveying this message and this story to our children, our brothers and sisters, then our children and our brothers will begin to believe what their teachers say to them, which totally contradicts the Quran and the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is essential that we go home today and we relate this story to our children, our brothers and our sisters and our families and all the people that we know. This is how and why Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was raised to the heaven. Let us now move on to the main part of the talk. The dissension of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, the return of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam for the second time to this world. I mentioned in the talk, the Dajjal a few weeks ago, that the Dajjal will appear and he will cause fitna wherever he goes. He will travel to the east, the west, the north, the south. He will cause fitna to the left and he will cause fitna to the right. He will travel to many different places causing fitna wherever he goes. And I mentioned that the last place he will appear will be in the east. The Muslims at the time will also be in the east. And there will be a fight between Dajjal and his army and the Muslims, Imam Mahdi, and the Muslims and their army. The Dajjal will kill a third. He will defeat a third. And he will fight a third. The Muslims, it will be nightfall, and the Muslims will be waiting for the morning so that they can fight the Dajjal and his army. When morning arrives, they will be informed that Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam has descended. In the hadith of Nawas bin Saman radiallahu ta'ala an, which can be found in Sahih Muslim, it is narrated, فَيَنْزَلُ عِنْدَ الْمَنَارَةِ الْبَيْضَاءِ شَرْكِيَّ دِمَشْكِ فِي مَفْرُودَتَيْنِ وَاضِئًا كَفَّيْحِ عَلَى أَجْنِحَةِ مَلَكَيْنِ إِذَا قَطَعَ رَأْسَهُ قَطَرْ وَإِذَا رَفَعَهُ تَحَذَّرَ مِنْهُ جُمَانٌ كَاللُّؤْلُؤِ. The Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend to the white minaret in the east of Damascus. He will be wearing two garments slightly dyed with saffron. His hands will be placed on the wings of two angels and Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend. In the hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, narrated by Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has described Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, فَأَمَّا عِيسَى فَأَحْمَرْ جَعْدٌ عَرِيدُ الصَّبْرِ. فَأَحْمَرْ, he will be reddish white in complexion. His hair will be soft and they will reach his ears. عَرِيدُ الصَّبْرِ, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will be well built. He will descend. His hands will be placed on the wings of two angels and he will descend. إِذَا طَعْفَى رَأْسَهُ قَطَرْ وَإِذَا رَفَعُوا تَحَذَّرَ مِنْهُ جُمَالٌ كَاللُّؤْلُؤِ. When he lowers his head, beads of perspiration will flow. And when he raises his head, beads like pearls will scatter. لَا يَحِلُّ لِكَافِرٍ يَجِدُ رِيحَ نَفَسِهِ إِلَّا مَاتْ وَنَفَسُهُ يَنْتَهِي حَيْثُ يَنْتَهِي تَرْفُ. Every kafir who smells his fragrance will die as soon as he smells his fragrance. And his breath will reach as far as his eye can see. In the hadith of Abu Umama al-Bahili, which can be found in Ibn Majah, it is narrated that Umm Shariq radiallahu ta'ala anha asked, Ya Rasulullah, فَأَيْنَ الْأَرَبْ يَوْمَ إِذِنْ. O Messenger of Allah, where will the Arabs be at the time? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, هُمْ قَلِيلٌ وَجُلُّهُمْ بِبَيْتِ الْمَقْدِسِ. That the Arabs at the time when the Dajjal causes all this fitna will be very less. and the majority of them will be in Bayt al-Maqdis. وإمامهم رجل صالح قد تقدم يصلي بحم الصبح إذ نزل عليهم عيسى بن مريم. The Imam at the time will be a very pious man. And we conclude in a lot of many other ahadith that this Imam will be Imam Mahdi. The Imam will be a very pious man and he will be on the verge of leading them in the morning prayer when Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will descend. فرجع ذلك الإمام ينكث يمشي القهقرة ليتقدم عيسى يصلي بالناس. When the Imam sees Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, he will take a few steps backwards from the musalla so Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam can come forward and lead the believers in prayer. فيدعو يده